This is Dr. Ritin Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, AJ Institute of Engineering and Technology, Mangaluru. Dear students, we have seen almost all the concepts of shock waves in our classes, and only the concept which is left behind in this chapter is the Reddy tube. Reddy tube is primarily called as Reddy shock tube. So what is this Reddy tube? Reddy tube is an hand operated shock tube which is capable of producing shock waves by using human energy. The Reddy tube consists of an stainless steel tube of about 30 millimeter diameter and length of nearly 1 meter. This Reddy tube is further divided into two sections. One is called as driver section, another one is called as a driven section. Each driver and driven section is of length 50 centimeter. So the driver and driven section is separated by a diaphragm, and diaphragm is generally made up of 0.1 millimeter thick aluminium or mylar or paper material. So this Reddy tube is fitted with an frictionless piston. So once the piston is pushed in, the gas which rushes from the, as a result, the gas gets compressed in the driver section, and the gas gets rushed from the driver section to the driven section. So when the piston is pushed hard, the compressed gas in the driver section ruptures the diaphragm. As a result, the gas rushes inside the driven section. The moving gas, suddenly when it enters the driven section, the region experiences shock, and it can be called as shock waves or shock wavefront. This shock wavefront which enters inside the driven section begins to travel towards the down end of the tube. So during it is traveling, it encounters the sensor S1 initially, which measures the pressure P1, temperature T1, density ρ1 and enthalpy H1 of the shock wavefront. So this shock wavefront travels further, reaches to the down end of the tube and reflects back, and when it is coming back, the sensor S2 measures the pressure as P2, temperature T2, density ρ2 and enthalpy H2. The condition is sustained until an expansion wave reflected from the down end stream of the tube arrives and neutralizes the compression partially. The signals from the sensor S1 and S2 are then sent to the cathode ray oscilloscope, and using the data, the Mach number, pressure and temperature of the shock waves generated can be estimated. So how to measure the Mach number using the Reddy tube? So we know the shock speed of the primary wavefront can be calculated using the formula Vs is equal to x by t, where x is the distance between the two sensors and t is the time taken by the shock of to travel between the two sensors. It is derived from the basic formula x is equal, and we know velocity is equal to distance traveled by time taken. So the shock waves which are created in the driven section goes towards the sensor S1, further reaches to the downwind of the stream and reflects back. And if x is and t is the time taken and x is the distance between the two sensor, we can measure what is the shock speed. Once we get the shock speed, we can calculate the Mach number using the formula M is equal to Vs by A, where Vs is the velocity of the primary shock waves generated inside the driven section divided by A is the speed of this sound. The speed of the sound can be measured using the formula A is equal to square root of gamma RT. So you can see now a picture of an Reddy shock tube which is installed in the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. You can see that there is a driver chamber and driven chamber. In between there is a Mylar membrane kept as a diaphragm, and using this Reddy tube they can measure what is the Mach number of the generated shock waves. Next, coming to the applications of the shock waves. There are different applications of the shock waves which is present in the day-to-day life. Some of the applications are listed below, which is there in your syllabus. One, biological cell information. By passing the shock waves of a different strength, DNA can be pushed inside the cell. The distinguishing feature is that functionality of the DNA will not be affected by impact of the shock waves. This had a wide biological application. By this, we can study various biological information of the cell. Next, shock waves are used in wood preservation. Using shock waves, chemical preservative in the form of solution could be pushed into the interior of the wood sample, such as bamboo, etc. This method makes the process of introduction of the preservative inside the wood much faster and more efficient. Using this method, the wood starts to have treated with the shock waves, after which they can withstand the microbial activity due to the presence of preservative which is present inside. The actual setup used for this purpose is actually known as shockwave reactors. You can see in the sawmill, etc., there are many shockwave reactors kept in the water, beneath the water, where the wood are logged in order to destroy the microbial activities. Next, uses in pencil industry. So while manufacturing the pencil in the industry, the wood is first should be softened by soaking in a polymer at 70 degrees centigrade for almost 3 hours and then dried. It takes a day for the wood to dry. In the modern process using shock waves, the wood is placed inside the liquid and shock waves are sent through it. The liquid gets inside the wood almost instantaneously. Otherwise, generally it takes several days, but here it can be done within hours. The wood is taken out and required no longer time for drying. The treated wood is next used for the process without any delay. It's an instantaneous process almost. Next, kidney stone treatment. The shockwaves are used in the kidney stone treatment. It is actually the process is called as extracorporeal lithotripsy, to shatter the kidney stone into the smaller fragments, after which they passed out of the body smoothly through the urinary tracts. It is actually a painless technique to remove the kidney stones from the kidney. Next, it is used in the gas dynamic studies. The extreme conditions of the pressure, temperature, which are produced in the shockwaves enables A shock tube enables the study of high temperature gas dynamics. This knowledge is very crucial for supersonic motion of the body, hypersonic re-entry of the space vehicle in the atmosphere, etc. We know the space shuttle, when it is sent to an atmosphere, we should know what happens when different kinds of gases comes and hits the space shuttle and different conditions, etc. So these conditions, extreme conditions, can be studied using the shock waves. Apart from these, shock waves are generally assisted in needleless drug delivery. The drug is injected towards the skin inside the body, and it is also used for treatment of dry borewell to get recharge, etc. So regarding the problems, there are two problems, simple problems given in your syllabus. So let us deal with the first one. In a ready tube experiment, time taken by the shock waves to travel between the two sensors is 180 microseconds. If the distance between the two sensor is 120 millimeter, find the value of m and mu, value of Mach number and Mach angle. So we know Mach number m is equal to Vs divided by a, where Vs is the velocity of the shock waves. So in order to calculate the velocity of the shock waves, we know the information given in the problem is distance between the two sensors is 120 micromillimeter, and the time taken by the shocks travel between the two sensors is 180 micrometer. So we can calculate Vs, that is equal to 120 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter divided by 180 into 10 to the power minus 6 second. Convert microsecond into second and millimeter into meter. So once you do this one, you can get what is the velocity of the shock wave front. And regarding A, but in the question, the A, small letter A, velocity of the sound in the medium is not given. Hence, we can take the value as 333 meter per second, which at standard temperature and pressure, the sound travels with a velocity of 332 meter per second. Hence, we can calculate what is the Mach number using Vs. Anyways, we can determine by using the formula X by T, and A, you can take it as 332 meter per second and calculate what is the Mach number. And once you get the Mach number, you can get the value of mu, which is a Mach angle, using the formula mu is equal to sine inverse of 1 by m. What is m? M, we got it in the last one. So substitute that one, 1 by m, and take sine inverse of that 1 by m. You can get what is the Mach angle. And regarding the second problem, in an experiment using a ready tube, it was found that time taken to travel between the two sensors is 195 microseconds, distance between the two sensors is 100 millimeter. Find the value of m. So it is a very simple problem. Similarly, how we did in the first case, m is equal to vs divided by a. Here, however, the value of a is given as 340 meter per second. You can take a is equal to 340 meter per second. And you can calculate what is Vs as 100 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 195 into 10 to the power minus 6 fetches you the value of Vs. You can calculate the value of M. M is equal to 195 divided by 100 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 195 10 to the power minus 6 divided by 340 gives you the value of M. Suppose if the value of A is not given, but anyways it is given, if suppose it is not given, you can calculate using the formula A is equal to square root of gamma RT, and gamma is equal to 1.4, and R is a real gas constant. You can take it as 8.3 or even 2008 joule kg per Kelvin to the power minus 1, and temperature, ambient temperature is given as 300 Kelvin. So in this way, we complete the syllabus of shock waves. I repeat again, we have seen almost all the concepts in the shock waves. One is what is Mach number, what is speed of the sound, and we have seen what is ultrasonic wave, we have seen what is subsonic wave, and we have seen what are the conservation of energy, mass and momentum, and we have seen the different properties of the shock wave front, different kinds of shock waves, strong shock waves, weak shock waves, and also we saw what is ready tube, etc. Thank you.